I live in a different house now, so that's why I haven't been YouTubing. So I'm basically going to show you our setup here. Here's our plant table here. And here's the grow room slash chicken brooder, but they're getting a little big. I've been so busy with work, I haven't been able to build anything outside with this quick move. So it's basically they graduated from this container down there to a dog kennel. They're going through about one of these things of feed every other day, about a half a thing of water a day. Just tilted. I wasn't ready for this. So, but hey, you learn best by jumping straight in, head first. This one here, this guy here is always, ever since he's a little chick, he's always been the one that's come up and pecked and did all that. I think it's a female too. Now this other black one's trying to get in on it. I think down there is going to be a cock. The rest of them, I don't see anything else developing too much. Of course, I've never had chickens, so they all could be, for all I know. Straight run. Oh, I guess there is a black one back there. That has a... I'm still working on this focus, too, on this phone. LG Optimus. Over here, we're working with a metal halide. I'm going to show you where this stuff is going eventually, but right now, these are all planted by seed. These are just trees. Mainly, these are all pear, these first one and a quarter row, and the rest are all black locusts. Except for this thing. I do not know what that is. Somehow it got mixed in with the black locust. I mean, it could be, but it's not showing the legume-type leaf here. So, I thought it was like a sunflower or something. And from my prior video, here's the light fixture I made. It's doing good for sprouting things. Not doing too good with my gardening this year. Especially when I'm starting with a farm field. Using garden soil. And it looks like this gardening soil that I got for this, mixed with my stuff, it has a lamb's quarter seed in it. I figured it'd be weed seed, but we eat lamb's quarter anyway. In here, just a little more grown stuff. It's just, we got goji berries. Toothache plant, valerian, San Marzano tomatoes in there. What else do we got? And some other plants. I'll get more into detail of that some other time. We're slowly putting some reflective material up. We're slowly doing some reflective material. Okay, over here, some more trees. Basically, it's the same as the other one, which I haven't even looked in there, but it's... Oh, wow. So putting the saran wrap over really, really boosted everything, which I expected. I just got lazy on this one over here. I need to water these, because we're going out of town for, a week, and these containers seem to, the top dries up quickly, but I don't know if it's all the way through or not, so it's hard to really tell. I've been watering them with that stainless steel water down there. So hopefully these recordings are better than the cheap camcorder I was using. Usually when they get like that, I just do some water. What I might do is put a couple inches of water in the bottom of this. I don't have any timed watering system in here. That might be another project. So that way, this is going to be our grow room for the winter. And even summer months, I'm thinking for greens. So I calculated the electric bill. It's cheaper to pay the electric bill, which I forget, I calculated out to be, I don't know, $15 a month or something like that. $15, $20. But it's cheaper to pay that than to go buy organic greens from the store. What are you peeking your head out there for, huh? So that's the rundown. And by the way, it does not smell. The chickens don't. When they're in a Tupperware container, they stayed in there for 2 or 3 weeks, and then they started being able to jump. So they went in here, and basically, I've had this bedding in here since February. It's April. I think it's right at the beginning of March I put new bedding in here. And it's been the same stuff. Now I'll kick a bunch of it out, and I'll put it back in every other day. But it's just now getting the point of smelling. So as long as you change it and keep up on it, you're fine. And I just haven't changed it because I've been building that cage outside and I want to get them outside. It's just that we're in April and we're getting snow. So it's been a cold spring so far with all of our negative temperatures and negative 30 and so. So, all right, well, that's about it. I guess I can show you the window where the house plants are in real quick. All right, well, we got our house plants. Some of them are not functional, but we got our citrus, which since I showed you that pruning video, they've just gone crazy. And all the leaves that come on are a lot larger than the originals. This one was a lemon. And some of these I just got, like my wife just buys me whatever. So, and I already had one of these palm trees. I'm trying for more functional. And here's a lemon tree. And we actually have a lemon that's on there. So that probably, I don't know how long it takes for those to get ripe, but I'm trying to make sure I keep water in here. And it looks like they used, what's that? Huh. It looks like they used rice hulls in the soil. So these can, when they start drying out, it dries out quick. Here's our, that lime tree that was big from the other video. It just keeps blasting off. And I got something eating it. I don't know what would be eating an inside plant like that. And especially the citrus plant. And over here we got our Moso bamboo, which constantly has browning on the leaves. I don't know if that's because it's in peat moss or what. Here's that Ming tree, which I moved this plant when it was, I think, 10, 20 degrees out. Fahrenheit. And it pretty much lost almost all of its leaves just from moving it probably 2 miles away. It took about 5 to 10 minutes to get here. But just that far away, it lost about all of its leaves. I put him down there. There's a guy I saw. What was his name? He has that Praxis thing. John, I think it was. But I saw he had some of these things in the soil, the nematodes or whatever they were. I might have to get some of that because I see, I don't know if they're fruit fly or fungus flies or not. Some of these, I think the citrus trees have little tiny flies that will fly out. So I don't know if they're responsible for that or not. This is a, not sure what that is. A lemon orange, I think just an orange seed. Over here, this is a blood orange, which in one day this thing wilted to nothing because the soil dried out and I didn't catch it in time. And I don't even know if it's going to recover. And I was looking more forward to the blood orange of all of them. I would have loved to have a little seedling of a blood orange. But it's, leaves staying kind of green there, but the rest of them are pretty crispy.
I don't know if it's going to branch out. And that's one of our mangoes. I think I showed how to do that. I don't remember. And here's the other mango. It's got a new leaf on it again. Which these seem to be pretty simple to grow. I think the soils I make, I always end up putting a lot of peat in them, which is probably not supposed to be, but I just had a big bag I'm still trying to use up from year like 10, 15 years ago. But yeah, that's a mango. This one's, I forget what kind this one is. This is a red mango here. This mango tasted a lot better, so. There's one of those flies. So I don't know if that's a fungus gnat. Little fast little sucker. I bet if I got those little things crawling my soil to eat them, the missus sees that and she'll freak out. In here is just an experiment. We got my paper pots from a video I did a long time ago. I had that whole box full of them. So we're trying the paper pots, and inside there we got golden currants. We're just going to plant those outside, hopefully this year. That about wraps up the things that are worth showing. This is what I have to work with now, this field out here. So, we're gardening from zero and starting from a farm field that was corn and beans for many, many years, and just started rotating wheat in the last people that were here. So, that's what we're going to be working with, and of course there's this true pine in a way, or spruce. Basically, I started some keyhole over there with just some perennials right beside that line of trees, which is black walnuts. There's a lot of walnut here. And then there's the woods back there. We got a couple acres, which you can't see. There's a collapsing bridge to get across the river back there. But back in the woods, there's some maples and a lot of sycamore trees. I'm going to try to put some locusts in there and oak. It was recently logged a couple years ago. So all the regrowth back there is probably 3-4 inches at the most. And just a bunch of dead maple. Just all the maple trees for some reason are all rotting out. And I don't know if that was from the deforestation or not, but that's about it. I'm hoping that, this line here, a lot of these are maples along the line. Property line. Hopefully I can get some taps in there next year. This year, the maple, instead of flowing in, January, or not January, February, March, it's like getting April till you can probably start tapping the maple trees. And one thing that's going on with black walnuts is you got raspberries, and it might be blackberries under there. I'll have to look. Which I almost pretty much never find wild blackberries. I don't think I ever have around this area. It's always raspberries everywhere. And I'm bringing in a few varieties of my own raspberries. I was just going to put a couple fences in between each of those walnuts, going the opposite way, this is perpendicular, and train the wild raspberries. That way it's easier to harvest them. Because right now there's all kinds of brambles, and there's multiflora rose also. Well, I'll give you a full tour later. So I'm just excited to have a new phone. Well, not the phone, but the high def video. So, all right.